Father, in the name of Jesus,
we're
asking at this time
Отец, мы молимся
that
в это время,
send your mighty power,
Господь, чтобы Ты снял свою силу, прикоснулся к каждому, изменил каждому.
Lord, I pray,
Отец, я молюсь, чтобы каждый здесь был кандидатом
Lord,
на
pray,
чудо. Отец, я молюсь,
right today,
здесь сегодня
you will do things that are miraculous.
Господь, Ты совершишь чудеса,
wonders here today, Lord.
Чудеса и знамения.
You confirm it among your people.
Господь, Ты подтвердишь
Thank
в жизни
you,
Твоего народа. Благодарен Тебе, Отче, за ответ. Во имя Иисуса Христа мы молимся. И все да скажут Аминь. Присаживайтесь. Мы говорим о царстве. Влияние царства в обществе.
Many people don't understand.
Много людей не понимают.
They think about church.
Они думают о церкви.
They do not think about the kingdom.
Но они не думают о царстве.
As you look at the Bible,
но когда вы смотрите на Библию,
in the Gospels you have the kingdom.
Да, в Евангелиях видите царство.
You come to Acts of the Apostles is the kingdom.
В Деяниях апостолов также.
You come to the epistles, the emphasis is on the kingdom.
Также и в посланиях видите о царстве говорится.
You have the church and also the kingdom.
У вас есть церковь и царство.
And we're talking about the influence.
Мы говорим о влиянии.
The impact,
вложение
of the kingdom on our society.
Что же может вложить царство в нашем обществе?
In the series I'm taking with you.
И сегодня о чем мы будем говорить? Я буду говорить о некоторых вещах в этом царстве. Сегодня я буду говорить о царстве веры. Я буду позже говорить о власти. А потом буду говорить о силе. И вы увидите,
что царство значит.
Что же значит царство для мира? Давайте начнем сегодня с этого царства.
There, one,
два слова есть там. Первое – царство.
Two,
второе – вера. Когда вы подумаете об этом, посмотрим на Матфея. С 23 стиха Матфея. Это где первый раз Христос упоминает о царстве. Матфея 4:23.
And it says, and Jesus went about all Galilee.
И ходил Иисус по всей Галилее.
Teaching in their synagogues.
Уча в синагогах их.
And preaching the good news, the gospel of the kingdom.
И проповедуя Евангелие Царствия.
Jesus went about.
Иисус ходил.
And also, what was he talking about?
И о чем же он говорил?
He was talking about the good news of the kingdom.
Он говорил о благой вести, о Евангелии.
The world in which we live.
Мир, в котором мы живем.
They do not understand.
Они не понимают.
That the kingdom brings good news.
Что царство имеет благую весть.
For many, many years in USSR.
Много лет тому назад в СССР
no place for God,
нет места для
no
Господа,
place for the kingdom,
для Царства,
no place for Christ,
для Христа,
until everything collapsed.
До момента, когда все
Now
было разрушено.
Realize,
но теперь мы начинаем понимать,
that the kingdom of God brings good news.
Что Царство Божье имеет в себе благую весть. И мы в Царстве имеете эту благую весть. Посмотрим на другое место Писания. Матфея 24. С 14 стиха. Матфея 24:14. И проповедуя будет сие Царствие, Евангелие
Царствие.
Здесь он опять говорит нам о том, что нам необходимо проповедовать Евангелие Царства. Оно будет проповедано по всей земле. Во свидетельство всем народам. И тогда настанет конец. Придет конец. В начале служения Христа. Царство. В конце его служения. Тоже говорится о царстве. Теперь он умер.
He was buried.
был похоронен.
Sunday he rose from the dead.
Но в третий день воскрес.
And he began to talk to his own disciples.
И он начал говорить своим ученикам.
What was he talking about to his disciples?
Что же он говорил своим ученикам?
Acts of the Apostles chapter 1.
Деяния, первая глава.
You see the emphasis of Christ again.
Видите, что опять Христос вспоминает, прежде чем он умер.
The kingdom.
Царство.
And then he rose from the dead.
И он воскрес.
Acts chapter 1 verse 3.
Деяния 1:3.
Here it tells us in Acts chapter 1 verse 3. To whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs.
Которым и явил себя живым по страданиям
Being seen of them 40 days.
Со многими верными доказательствами.
Speaking of things pertaining to the kingdom of God.
Продолжение 40 дней, являясь ими, говоря о Царстве Божьем.
Can you see that? That was the day he was going to go to heaven.
Это тот день, в котором он должен был пойти на небеса.
And just before he went to heaven.
И до того момента, прежде чем оставил землю.
Again about the kingdom.
Он говорил о Царстве.
Many things happened between chapter 1 and the last chapter of the Acts of the Apostles.
Много вещей произошло с первой главы до последней.
Eventually, the Acts of the Apostles, as it went on,
и в конце продолжается дальше.
The good news was being published.
Благая весть была распространена.
The kingdom was coming into the hearts of the people.
И Царство Божье было в сердцах
людей. Now you turn to Acts of the Apostles, the very last chapter.
Последняя глава Деяний апостолов.
Acts chapter 28.
28 глава.
And then you find the last verse there.
И посмотрим на последний стих.
It says in verse 31.
31 стих.
Preaching the kingdom of God and teaching those things which concern the Lord Jesus Christ.
Проповедуя Царствие Божие и уча о Господе Иисусе Христе.
With all confidence and no man forbidding him.
Со всяким дерзновением невозбранным.
Can you see the trend?
Вы видите, что здесь говорит?
From the beginning of the ministry of Christ.
От начала служения Христа.
Until the very end of the ministry of Christ.
До конца служения Христа.
After the resurrection.
После воскресения, до момента, когда он был воскрешен, церковь начала свое существование, и до конца, когда Дух Святой имел свое влияние, который помогал, давал силу крепость апостолам, проповедовать везде, и все это было еще царством. Что-то важное здесь.
If you look at the end of Matthew,
если посмотрите на конец Матфея,
there is a final word, there's an amen.
Последнее слово – аминь.
If you look at the end of Mark,
если посмотрите на Марка,
the very last part of Mark,
последняя часть
you're
Марка,
going to find a final word, amen.
Последнее слово – аминь.
If you look at the end of Luke,
если посмотрите на Луки,
that word appears again, amen.
Аминь – также последнее
if
слово.
If you look at the end of John,
в конце Иоанна.
You're going to find an amen.
Аминь, последнее
you
слово.
Come to the end of the Acts of the Apostles.
И теперь Деяния апостолов.
And that word amen is missing.
Но что-то мы видим, нет этого аминь там.
What's the implication of that?
Что же это значит?
The Gospels tell us the story of redemption.
Евангелие говорит нам об искуплении
and
через Христа.
Redemption is over, final.
И в конце концов мы видим, что
and
это искупление закончено. И теперь Деяния апостолов.
The acts are the actions.
Деяния – это действия.
The manifestations.
Проявления.
That they progress the process.
Прогресс.
Of establishing the kingdom.
От тогда, когда Царство
and there
было установлено.
Is not a final amen.
Но нет там аминь.
What they started,
что они начали?
We continue.
Я продолжу, Виктор.
What they started,
то, что они начали,
we continue.
Мы продолжаем.
That means then,
это значит,
the way they did it,
что то, что они делали,
and the means by which they did it,
и то, как они это сделали,
it has been transferred unto us.
Оно было передано нам вот почему нету точка.
It was the kingdom in Matthew.
Вот почему нету аминь.
Mark.
То есть после Матфея, там было аминь конец.
The kingdom in John.
Марка, после Лука, было аминь точка.
And the kingdom in the Acts of the Apostles. And then it says, it is not finished
yet. When
you enter into the kingdom,
the
Lord wants you to understand until you do your part.
nibudet ami nibudet toshki baka kalde isnas nizdelai for your sarsfas for your deyani.
Until he does his part.
Ve dojna suches vi sarsfas.
Until I do my part.
Ya dojna suches vi sarsfas. Ve dojne prinisti sarsfas.
There is no final amen.
Baka me says for me nizdelai mdela sarsfas nibudet toshki ami deyani apostle of.
You coming.
I have come.
He has come. So you can fulfill and finalize the final amen.
Tonkara de adnoisele. Sto bi bili ludi katore prodojit eti de yani apostle of do paslid nova amin kada hom pridiot.
The question is,
the main vapros,
how did that kingdom begin?
Kak jenashalos eta sarsfa.
The question is,
vapros,
how will that kingdom continue?
Akim je obros on prodojit rasprastranine eta vasarsfa.
They started by faith.
And that sarsfa nationalos vero you.
We continue in faith.
In May, prodojayem rasprasanin sarsfa vero you.
The climax, the culmination will come by faith.
Is sarsfa eta pridiot. He associates with that. Tolka vero you takshe.
I told you about the kingdom.
Yavam gavaru asarsfa.
Let's not talk about the faith.
Itepe devaite pagavarim avere.
So you can appreciate the kingdom faith.
Itepe. Ano dwa sa shitane sarsfa very sarsfa very.
Hebrews chapter 11.
Yevreim adinasta glava.
In Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6.
Yevreim adinasta glava.
It says, but without faith it is impossible to please God.
Amna pisa na ibo bez very ni vas mosh na ugodi bogo.
If you look at that verse very well,
yes, we pass more than harasho na ito mesa pisa.
It does not say it is difficult to please God.
Am nina pisa na shutiji lo ugodi bogo.
It said without faith.
Amna pisa na shu bez very.
It is impossible to please God.
Ni vas mosh na absolute na.
That is, if you are going to fulfill your part in the kingdom.
So yes, the visa hatite ugodit bogo. If
the kingdom in this land.
Yes, the way hatite prinesi sasa betu stranu.
Is to influence the whole nation.
Yes, the way hatite pavliya nafsias feri.
Without faith, it is impossible.
Daite yavam dam klush. Best very eto manize adela vera yes klush.
Impossible to please God.
He may not vero you. May gosh die in bogo.
He who comes to God.
Must
believe. It doesn't say may believe. It doesn't say perhaps he will have to believe. If you are going to enter the kingdom, stay in the kingdom, walk in the kingdom,
take
the kingdom to influence the nation. Faith is central. Faith is important. Faith is indispensable.
If there is
anything we must have,
it
will be the faith we have in Christ. Because without faith, it's impossible to please Him. He that wants to go must believe.
That
He
is. Show Him in on.
Who is he?
Show on, yes.
We're talking about God.
I come make over him.
He is not who the theologians say he
is. Make him a jivon boge.
God is not who the politicians say God is. God is not who the people here, the eastern people, who they say God is. Nobody knows me like myself. Nobody knows him like himself. Nobody knows God like himself. It will be very much impossible for people here on earth to tell us all about God. He has to tell us who he is.
Nam pravena raskazat.
And you cannot say no. Do you know a man more than he knows himself? Would you know God more than God knows himself?
You
must believe that he is who he says he is.
That
he can do what he says he can do.
That
kind of faith
that
leads us into the kingdom. When you come in by faith, you continue by faith. Some people start by faith.
I'm
saved.
I'm
born again. I'm redeemed. By faith. Then they continue by reasoning. They start in the spirit. They continue in the flesh. They start by faith. They continue by reasoning. And it never works that way. And so that is a faith that will bring the kingdom to influence the world. I came to know this faith
1964.
I was brought up by an atheist. I was educated by an atheist. He said there was no God. I learned about all the theories and all the philosophies. All the great mighty authors you think about in atheism. We were taught and drilled. But 1964, I came in contact with the gospel. The news of the kingdom. Then I realized that all those things I was taught, that it will not hold water. Atheism is good when there's no problem. When there's no confusion. When there's no conflict. When everything is going on smoothly. Atheism appears alright. And your car is riding very well. What is petrol in the car? And the smoothness, there's no pothole on the road. No challenges, no sickness. Atheism was good thus far. But when you come to the crossroad of life, when there are questions begging for an answer, you cannot find solution. When they turn into poison, when there's problem in the west and problem in the east and problem in the north and problem in the and all the philosophies do not have any answer,
they
will begin to realize that we need something more than what they told us. And that 1964, I came in contact with the Lord himself. All of a sudden, all my unbelief was taken away. I knew in a very personal way that Jesus became my Savior and Lord.
Jesus Christus Shastu Moye Jesus
in the school of the atheists. I knew.
Yeah, Sam Sibias now.
He knew.
Yes, now.
All the other people around me knew you.
If they just say that river crook, but yeah, they just told
that something happened.
Says Nali shows that certain shall have come to the
place. That happened more than 40 years
and
ago.
And that bilauje soroka leta munazad.
That thing is still living big and strong inside me.
Eta vera katore prishla kamneta gda anasio ishorasio ukreplai savamnedo sekpo.
And since that time,
it's tough over me.
This good news of the kingdom.
Eta blagaya vesje van.
Taking me to America. To Canada.
Canada.
To Singapore.
Singapore.
To Malaysia.
Malaysia.
And to Thailand.
Thailand.
To many countries in Africa. And I've seen this gospel of the kingdom. And it works universally everywhere. It's an introduction I'm just giving to you today. As I talk to you on kingdom faith.
When
you look at this Hebrews chapter 11, as you look at Hebrews chapter 11, you're going to see some things about this kingdom faith. Number one, the definition of the kingdom faith.
You
must understand the definition, description of kingdom faith. If you don't know the definition and description, how will you be able to know when you have it? If you look at Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. Hebrews 11 verse 1. Now faith is. Stop there for a moment. It doesn't say then faith was.
There
are many people that tell us today that God was wonderful in the Old Testament.
So that Bog days for all that comes of it.
A God who can divide the Red Sea.
That Bog takda
wonderful. A God that can make the Jericho walls to fall down.
Wonderful.
And a God that can defeat Goliath by the throwing of a stone.
That on build Goliath.
That God was wonderful.
Football, Bill Precrash.
Oh, the theologians tell us.
No, it's theology.
That when Jesus came to this world, he was the express image of the Father.
Sto on Bill, the Spirit of Atragenia
Bola. He walked in Galilee.
On Hadil Pogali.
He was in Nazareth.
On Hadil Pogali.
He was in Jerusalem.
Jerusalem.
Oh, they say, yes, they believe in miracles.
E Ludi. Verily,
they believe in the miracles of the past.
No, and if very live should this approach lava theology.
The age of miracle is gone. That means they should read this verse.
No, veto Mr. Pisan in attack na pisana.
Then faith was.
Yes, and Bila.
But you know what the Bible says?
No, we read the Bible again.
Now,
yes, na shesi shas.
Today,
Sivonia.
At this time,
na eto vremia.
Now, at this time,
Sivonia na eto mes.
Eks
vera je yest.
That means it's not something of the past.
Etas na shet anoni prosh la eshto.
Don't relegate your God to the past.
Slusha ni pas volim adalet wo ivo goda na prosh la vremia.
I have not changed.
Yet only shown his men in shive only his men usa.
What he did at that time.
Toshon zela utakda.
Is still able to do today.
Onsio ishas pas sobin satvoritivoria.
We were at the stadium. And the place was packed full. There was a boy that came there with no leg.
He had one leg good. The
other leg was only flesh, no bone.
From
his hip to his toe.
To his nose bedra.
Only flesh with no bone.
The pulse. Eta tolka miasa. Nevela ni agavo coste.
And we began to pray.
Ime nashali malisa na stadion.
As we began to pray.
Ipaka mi malilis.
We were still closing our eyes.
So isho nashi glaza bilisa.
We had not finished the prayer.
Ne isho nisa konshili malitsa.
And then I had a shout.
If shrug luti nashali krishas.
The boy came out.
I eta parin viskashi.
And the woman ran after him.
Imama nashala dagna.
In the middle of that prayer, God had created bone in a place where there was no bone.
Box at orange shoulder, if I have And I say
now faith is.
И потому я говорю сегодня, что вера, которая была, она и есть сегодня также.
That place where you are.
Там, где бы ты не был.
That place where you sit
там, где бы ты не сидел.
I want to tell you.
Я хочу вам сегодня утвердить.
So,
вера, вера, которая была, она все еще сегодня есть.
I was in Namibia.
Я был в стране Намибии.
And in this Namibia.
И в этой стране.
That was my first time there.
Я первый раз вообще.
They call the name of the city Oshakati.
Ошакати был название этого города.
The people were spread out in the stadium.
Люди заполнили стадион.
There was this girl.
И была там
девушка. Totally paralyzed.
Она была полностью парализована.
Totally paralyzed.
И руки, и ноги.
To move from one place to the other.
И чтобы передвигаться с одного места на другое.
Crawling like an animal.
Она ползала как животное по полу.
On the 4th of May last year.
No, первое мая прошлого года.
As we were there.
Пока мы там были.
I announced to them.
Я им заявлял.
Today.
Что сегодня? Что вера, что еще жива.
And I said, we're going to pray. And that's when I mentioned the name of Jesus. His name is as powerful as when he was on earth.
So
I said, let us pray. I remember this girl, 12 years of age. She was born in that condition. She had never taken a step in her life. And then I told them, when I mentioned Jesus,
they would
show up.
Что Иисус появится позаду.
Have you ever had that experience before?
Это когда-нибудь переживали?
You're talking about somebody.
Что вы говорите о ком-то?
And as we're talking about him.
И вы только что начали говорить о ком-то?
You look back.
И вы посмотрели?
Oh, I was just talking about you.
И вот он появился. И вы, я только что о тебе говорил.
Have you ever that experience before?
Было ли у вас такое?
So I told them.
И я им сказал.
I said, when I start talking about Jesus.
Что когда я начну говорить об Иисусе.
They will show up.
Он появится обязательно.
Today.
И сейчас мы здесь с вами. И я говорю об Иисусе. Иисус явится в этом зале сегодня.
And so we began to pray.
И мы начали молиться.
And I said, Lord Jesus.
И я сказал, Господь Иисус.
And lo and behold,
the day prepared to
he came and stood before that
12-year-old
girl. And the girl saw Jesus.
И эта девушка увидела живого Иисуса.
Jesus pointed at her.
Иисус протянул руку на нее так.
And said, "Get up."
И сказал ей, "Stand."
Immediately.
И тут же.
Hands, okay.
Ее руки упрямились. Ноги упрямились.
And the girl began to run.
И эта девушка побежала по залу.
Jesus we're talking about.
Это об этом Иисусе я все еще говорю.
And I say, now, today.
И я вам заявляю сегодня.
In this auditorium.
Что прямо в этом зале.
In Kiev.
В Киеве, Украина.
Now, faith is.
Что вера же, yes.
Not yesterday.
Не вчера была.
Not tomorrow.
Не послезавтра будет.
Today.
Сегодня.
Faith
вера. Yes.
Number one.
Первое.
The definition of faith.
Вера, yes.
Faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Вера, yes. Осуществление.
And it is the evidence of things not seen.
И уверенность невидимым.
What you have not seen.
То, что еще не видели. То, что вы еще не видите.
What you are hoping for.
Придет вам, когда вы поверите, что уже есть. To
what you are desiring.
To
this is the day of the manifestation. Number two. The distinction of faith. There is the definition.
Yes, определение
веры. Number two, there is the distinction.
Потом есть то, что отличительная черта веры.
When we talk about distinction,
отличительная черта веры.
I'm talking about the differentiation.
Это то, что отличает веры.
I'm talking about something that sets you apart.
То, что отличает что-то от другого.
That you are not like every other Dick and Harry.
То, что вы отличаете от других людей. То, что отличает
вас. Many years ago.
Несколько лет назад.
God decided
Бог,
He was going to do something general.
Решил, что он что-то сделает.
But you know, faith makes you to come apart.
Вера отличает человека от прочих людей. Если вы верите, вера вас поднимает на другой уровень.
God does not act to a man of faith like he acts to everybody else.
Послушайте, друзья, когда человек начинает верить в Богу, как он просит, Бог отличает этого человека, выделяет его от толпы.
God said in his word that death was going to pass to all men.
So Buddha smelt всем человеком.
Everybody coming into this world,
if sick to приходить в эту землю,
they will end up in the grave.
Они однажды умрут.
But there is a man.
Но был человек.
His name is Enoch.
Его звали Енох.
He was set apart.
Енох он был отличен.
Although everybody was supposed to die.
Видели уса.
By faith, Enoch did not see
this. Faith
distinguished him.
No, vero you, Enoch knew woman. Vera,
in chapter 11.
Vete glave, abeto mi reishi.
I'm going to bring a flood.
Bog govori što ja.
Everybody will perish.
Ya uništuju zemlju patopom.
Except a man of faith.
Chrome sheluveka katore paverio.
By faith, Noah was warned of the flood to come.
Vera, you know, ni mog bit unistujon patopom, but amusha vera atlishae sheluveka, videlae sheluveka.
Although the flood swallowed up everybody,
in his mountain atosh to see asane pa
biblio patopom. But this man of faith, Noah,
no sheluveka tore paveril bil videlin atlishon.
The Lord made a distinction, a differentiation.
In bog segda pravodit atlishae meju.
As you come today,
I
say, I have faith in God.
It
will set you apart.
It
will make you totally different. God
does
not act a man of faith, a woman of faith. Like he acts to everybody else.
Бог only pas stupid человеком very. Так же, как он за всеми
поступает.
И когда вы сегодня придете, скажете, я тебя буду верить, Господь.
God is going to make a difference of you.
Бог вас отличит от прошлого.
And what had never happened,
и то, что вы никогда не переживали,
will make it happen
то,
in your
что вы никогда не видели, вы начнете переживать
в твоей жизни.
Вот, это и есть отличительная черта веры.
We were in Pretoria, South Africa.
Я был в одном городе, Pretoria, Южная Африка.
And then I was talking to the people.
I said, they had to
wait upon the law.
Shall renew their strength.
And they shall mount up like eagles.
And
I was describing the eagles to the people.
And told
them, the eagle is not like any other bird. The eagle has sharp eyesight.
And
the eagle
is
can see very far.
It should
far beyond any other bird. There was somebody in that meeting. While I was talking about the eyesight and the vision of the eagle. What happened to this brother? His name, Brother Jacobs, in Pretoria.
He was Vali Brak Yakov, Omjil Pretoria.
He was at the light. And the robbers wanted to take the car from him.
Стоял возле светофора и прибежали воры, а они собрать его машину.
They shot him in the eye.
И с пистолетом они
pulled him away from the car.
И пуля попала прямо в глаз.
And they took the car away.
И собрали его машину.
So
he no пуля в его глаза.
They took him to the hospital.
Его достали по больнице.
They removed that bad eye.
И они удалили то орошее глаз.
And the doctors gave him plastic eye.
И они там местили вместо орошего глаза.
And Brother Jacob was in the machine.
Искусственные глаза.
And here I was talking about the eagle.
И я он бил там один глаз.
And I said today.
И я говорил о глаза орла.
Vision of an eagle.
И я говорю, Бог может дать вам такое же зрение, как у орла.
And we began to pray.
И я начал молиться.
After the prayer,
после молитвы,
it was Friday night.
Это было пятницу вечером.
They went back home.
Он уехал домой.
When Brother Jacob woke up in the morning,
ничего не чувствовал.
The plastic eye could see.
Look at them plastic. No, sir. Он стал видеть в этом пластическом глазе. Glasgow.
So he began to, he was wondering.
И он начал думать, что со мной произошло.
He came to the meeting on Saturday.
Он пришел на второй день в субботу.
He said, Pastor, I don't understand.
И говорит, пастор, я что-то не понял.
My plastic eye can see.
Мои пластические глаза вижу сквозь туда положили.
Я вижу. I told him, go back to your doctor.
Я направил его к врачу.
He got to his doctor.
Он попал к врачу.
They tested him and the plastic eye could see.
Они проверили его и сказали, слушай, мне тоже не понял.
The doctor wanted to bring out the plastic eye.
Они сказали, давай, может быть, удалить надо это
предыдущее искусство. Because new nerves have grown with the plastic eye.
Они не могли его удостать это пластическое, потому что вместо пластика уже было настоящее, все выросло, как настоящий глаз. Мы не могли его достать.
I saw brother Jacob many years after.
Я увидел этого Иакова, год спустя.
And I said, Jacob, how is your plastic eye?
Я сказал, Иаков, что там твоим пластиком?
He said, Pastor, my plastic eye seems good.
Он говорит, пастор, это пластика работает лучше, чем настоящий глаз.
You say, I've never had that before. That's what I told the distinction of kingdom faith. Because kingdom faith distinguishes you. Number three is the decision of kingdom faith. You know, if you're going to live by faith, you're going to be a man of decision. It's in that Hebrews chapter 11. Abraham had been living his regular life.
Abraham жил нормально и жизнь до того.
A normal life.
Он жил нормально как все.
It was just a human life.
Он жил просто как человек.
He was already 75 years of age. And then God said, Abraham.
If Drew Бог взывал к нему Авраам.
When God calls your name,
если Бог тебя позовет,
He has something to say.
Это значит, что точно у него какая-то задача есть для тебя.
He's not going to talk to your mind.
Он просто не будет тебя говорить через ум.
He's not going to talk to your brain.
Он не будет говорить тебя через мозг.
If God spoke to your brain,
Бог не говорит через мозг.
He's speaking to your reasoning.
Он говорит, может быть, через того, чтобы ты подумал.
It will blow you away.
Если он скажет твоему разуму,
He speaks to your faith.
Твоя голова взорвется, поэтому он никогда не говорит голову. Он говорит душу, сердце.
And then Abraham said, Here am I, Lord.
И Авраам сказал, да, Господь.
And the Lord said, At the age of 75, I want to start a program, a project with you.
И Бог ему сказал, слушай, в 75 лет я хочу с тобой начинать программу.
I'm going to give you a child.
Я дам тебе ребенка.
I'm going to lead you to a place.
И я тебя поведу.
You're going to be a blessing to all the families of the earth.
И ты будешь благословенным для всех.
The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11, reading there from verse 8, by faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, he obeyed. And he went out, not knowing whither he went.
Верою Авраам повиновался призванию идти в страну, которую имел, получив наследие, и пошел, не зная, куда идет.
That is because God knows the way.
Это потому что Бог он не знает дорогу куда он идет.
And the Lord has called you.
Но это потому что Бог так знает дорогу.
Close your eyes and keep on following the Lord.
И когда Бог тебя зовет, ты даже не знаешь дорогу. Он так знает дорогу.
He took a decision.
Ты можешь даже закрыть глазами пойти за ним.
I close my eyes and follow the Lord.
И поэтому он поверил, что я даже пойду, даже если я не буду знать дорогу.
I don't know where I am going.
Я не знаю куда у меня зовет.
And yet the Lord is calling me.
Но Бог меня зовет.
By faith, he went out, not knowing where he was going.
Official is the man is there, could I idiot?
Many years ago, 1973, I was lecturing mathematics at the university.
Я преподавал математику в университете.
And then, as a lecturer,
и будучи преподавателем,
I had made a first class in mathematics.
Я, no, закончил красным дипломом.
I was doing my normal research.
Я был исследователем математики.
At a good place.
И я, no, занял хорошую должность.
And then God showed me a crowd of people.
И вдруг я увидел видение, Бог мне показал толпу.
Thousands, I could not see the end.
Тысячи, я не мог видеть конец.
And the Lord was saying, I'm going to make you a preacher.
И Бог мне сказал, слушай, ты математик, да?
And you're going to reach out to hundreds of thousands of people.
Я тебя зову быть проповедником, и ты спасешь тысячи, тысячи.
And we have a Bible study that began with 15 people.
И я так начал собрать людей, 15 человек в начале.
And when you have 15 people in your congregation,
и когда у тебя 15 человек,
and the Lord is showing you a vision of hundreds of thousands of people,
а Бог показывает мне, ну, сотни тысяч людей,
you need to take a decision.
И мне пришлось принять решение.
What am I going to do?
Get a
good job at the university.
Только 15 человек. Оставить, ну, хорошую работу, хорошую должность. Оставить хорошую перспективу.
And yet by faith.
И идти спасти 15 человек.
A decision of faith.
Нужно было принять решение веры.
And the Lord is talking to you today.
Слушайте, есть кто-то здесь.
And he's saying, you are going to have to step out.
Я тебя призывал сделать шаг веры.
And make a decision.
Но шаг веры. Трудный шаг.
A decision from your head.
Не шаг с твоей головы.
Decision from the mind.
A
decision from the examples of other people. It's going to be a decision of faith like
Abraham.
And then I have the destination of kingdom faith.
Number one,
you have the definition of kingdom faith. Number two, the distinction of kingdom faith. Number three, the decision of kingdom faith. Number four, is the destination of kingdom faith.
Пункт назначения веры.
We're told in verse 10.
Десятом стихе.
For he looked for a city.
Ибо он ожидал города.
Which are foundations. Whose builder and maker is God.
Которого художник и строитель Бог.
The reason we take the first step.
Почему нам надо сделать первый шаг?
Is so that we'll keep on walking.
Чтобы мы могли продвигаться по
вере. Until the final last step.
Идти пока мы не дойдем до пункта назначения.
The first step brings us into the kingdom here on earth.
Первый шаг.
The final step brings us to the kingdom there in heaven.
Но последний шаг приводит нас в царство на небеса.
You take the first step, you enter the kingdom here on earth. You take the final step, it leads you to heaven. It is that destination before you.
Наша цель с вами. Это единственное наше предназначение.
You are looking forward to.
Мы ждем неба. Тебе нужно постоянно думать о небе.
You have that in mind.
Всегда, чем бы вы ни занимались, надо всегда думать о том, что пункт назначения это дойти до неба.
That's why they became what they became.
Вот почему эти люди стали великими в Библии.
Number five, the demonstration of kingdom faith.
И пятый пункт, это проявление веры.
You see, faith is not passive.
Faith
is not important.
Faith
is not something that is, you know, I have faith. But whenever you see it, it's something that comes in demonstration. Verses 11 and 12. That through faith, Sarah had strength to conceive.
God, she is very Sarah Zaberemenla.
You know, she was already old.
Sarah уже была no star.
When a woman is already 80 years of age.
Yes, the женщина уже 80 лет.
89 years of age.
89 лет.
And yet, what the Lord had promised.
И все таки Бог обещал.
I am still going to fulfill.
So я исполню мое обетование для тебя.
That is something wonderful.
Это что-то чудесное.
And so you have the demonstration of faith.
Итак, есть проявление веры.
You know, sometimes when I travel around,
in America,
especially when I go to a place like America,
and
they be asking me some of these things that take place, they say, that's only in Africa that can happen.
Часто мне говорят, что чудеса такие возможны только в Африке.
We have a woman in Nigeria.
У нас была женщина в Нигерии.
In Nigeria, when you are married,
if there
is no child,
it's
like a calamity. All the people around will be looking at you as if, you know, what happened to you? This woman was sick. She was taken to the hospital. And when she was at the hospital, they needed to perform operation. And the operation was to remove her productive system. And so they told the husband to come and sign. And the woman had no child at all.
И она не должна была видеть.
But Uma was unconscious.
No, то есть она уже была в потерянном сознании.
The husband put his signature down.
Поэтому муж подписал,
чтобы спасли ее жизнь. And perform the operation.
Чтобы могли спасти ее жизнь.
So they removed the productive system.
И они удалили все.
After the woman got well, she began to have the normal desire to have a child.
Her
husband says, I love you the way you are. I
made
a choice, I put my signature down. So there's no problem. Be with me, I'm with you.
But
the woman came to church.
So
I went in church. I was praying. Then I saw her in the spirit. And by the gift of the word of knowledge, I pointed where she was. I said, that woman there.
You have
an operation.
And you're
talking with the productive system.
And
God pray for you and God is going to give you a child. Only an illiterate can say that. Only an illiterate can say
that. Who can say that? Either you are неграмотный, чтобы так говорить, что после удаления человек будет иметь ребенка.
Only those who didn't go to school should say that.
Может быть, ты не ходил в школу вообще, ты как можешь о таком вообще думать?
Thank you, I went to school.
Слушайте, а я как раз такой,
что... I studied science.
Я ходил в школу.
I studied mathematics.
Изучал науку.
I did what they call complex variables.
Я изучал математику, сложные науки, сложные математики.
I published papers in science.
Я печатал, мои труды печатали по науке.
But my God is greater than mathematics.
Но мой Бог выше математики.
My God is greater than your encyclopedia.
So
don't wonder, worry what they say.
God
says something more than what your doctor
says.
So I said, raise up your hand. And then I prayed.
And
I said, go buy baby things because the baby is coming.
He said, go buy baby things because the baby is coming.
To cut a long story short.
Wow, show me. Не рассказывать много.
That woman became pregnant.
Она забеременела.
Went to the hospital.
Пошла в врачу.
Then after 5 months.
И после 5 месяцев.
The baby was out like that.
Уже была видна беременность.
She said, doctor, come and see.
И она говорит, врачи, слушайте.
Miracle.
У меня чудо.
Doctor said, no, it's psychology.
Они сказали, нет, это у тебя просто психологи, у тебя проблема.
But when those church people, when they play psychology on you.
Они говорят, это ты в церкви одурили. Это ты думаешь, что ты беременна.
Thank God at the 9 months.
Но через 9 месяцев.
Psychology became reality.
Психология превратилась в реальность.
And then she delivered in that same hospital.
В этой же больнице, где говорили психологи, они приняли у нее роды.
And the woman came to church with the baby.
Yeah, на previous night we were going
to circle. And the doctor came with the woman to the church.
Oh, glory to God! И этот врач сказал, я пойду с тобой в эту церковь. И сам врач пришел в церковь, вместе с этим ребенком, и говорит, все, я теперь верю.
There is a God of miracles.
Yes, Bog should have told me. Yes, but I'm Zale Simonia. I'm promised, yes, but I'm Zale.
Now it is your turn.
I thought you're ushering.
If you've never seen a miracle,
yes, that they should have been, should have said that you're ushering.
God's miracle is here today.
And the Bog should have, I'm pursued the promise, the boys.
Kingdom,
why
don't you rise on your feet and see a demonstration?
Yeah, be увидим проявление
of the kingdom faith.
Царство Божьего.
You enter by faith.
Мы войдем в
царство. You establish by faith.
Через веру.
You experience God by faith.
Мы идем по царству по вере.
Whatever the challenge may be.
И в чем бы не было проблема.
As we serve the God that now is.
И когда мы будем служить Богу.
As we are praying to the God that now is.
The
God of the present day.
Yes, Bog,
with
yes.
A great power.
On premise,
a God who has not changed.
On his very
a God who is mighty.
On velik.
Is coming right there where you are
on
now. And whatever your need may be. If you are sick. We're going to pray. If anybody is blind, we're going to pray. If you have arthritic pains, we're going to pray. If you have paralyzed and lame, we're going to pray. If you brought any child that has mental problems, we're going to pray. And if you have that backache, we're going to pray. If your disc has leached, and so it's giving you excruciating pain,
we're going to pray.
Somebody here has done operation,
and
after the operation, they did something wrong, and so you are suffering because of that.
We're going to pray.
Somebody over there, you are hearing noise in your ear, mysterious noise in your ear. We're going to pray.
And
there's somebody having power, and then when you go to the bathroom, the pile.
Yes. Gimaroi.
As we pray,
everything
will clear away.
And
you have cataract in your eyes.
The
Lord is going to take it away.
The
person that has HIV AIDS,
just
Now face it. And right there, that
Kingdom faith.
When I mention the name of Jesus,
Jesus
will show up right here. After the prayer, you will check up yourself. It's done. Let's pray together now.
Father,
in the name of Jesus.
Oh, God,
This is the day of miracles. The day of signs and wonders. The day of the supernatural. I pray for those deaf ears.
Deaf
ears, I command you be open in Jesus' name. That terrible pain at your back, I command that pain at the back vanish away in Jesus' name. The dimness of eyes,
problem of glasses,
the blindness in your eye,
I command
the spirit of blindness.
The
pain of arthritis, the paralysis in your body, one leg that is shorter than the other. I pray.
Above, boy,
my
balloons.
Power.
Demonstrate
the miracle now.
Touch her. Paul, break us this name.
Everybody said amen.
He showed us first clean to best the road. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
First clean to Bogu. Amen.
Now face
verra, yes.
Now miracle eight.
Yes.
Now power
eight.
Now
yes.
Healing
eight.
Now
yes.
Deliverance
eight. Yes.
Where there is faith, there is miracle.
This.
Where there is faith, there is healing. Where there is faith, there is deliverance.
It's
there already. Check up now. Check up yourself.
Check
up yourself. If you were not able to bend before, bend and get up. If your eyes were dim before, look up at me here. If you were deaf before, check it up.
Now
faith is.
And
now power is.
Yes.
Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you, Bogu, Slavu. Спасибо вам большое.
You can't believe this now.
Хотел бы засвидетельствовать.
Now, of course, you know, as a pastor concerned, you will not expect this testimony, but it's the truth.
Конечно, вы, наверное, не будете ожидать такого свидетельства от пастора, но это правда.
People who are close to me, my wife and, you know, these, you know, secretaries and assistants, they know that, you know, this is true.
Люди, которые близко ко мне, моя супруга и люди, которые работают в офисе, мои помощники, они знают, что это правда.
One time, we were traveling from our house to the church.
Однажды мы ехали из дома в церковь.
And there was a temple, a Mormon temple, as you know, the Mormon church. Yeah, their temple, they had built a temple just at the roundabout of the city. And in that temple, if you are in the car, you could see that there's something written on it. But I didn't know. I'd been seeing it for like, that temple. I knew it was there maybe for a year, but I never knew there was something written on it.
Вообще, на пути от моего дома до церкви есть мормонский храм такой. И мы когда ехали, я постоянно его видел. И я видел, что там что-то написано, но я не видел, что на нем написано. Просто знал, что там какая-то надпись.
But, you know, it is so funny. There has been several times when I will sit down here in front, just beside my wife, and I will be telling the ushers and that why should they put on the screen with words when there is nothing there to read, you know. So my wife would tell me, you mean you don't see that? I said, no. She said, go for checkup. And you know, I would say, no, I think that thing is faulty. So for maybe a year, I didn't pay attention to that. But when that incident happened with the building, there were four other people with me, my wife and three other people in the same car. So I quickly told other people, now I know this is serious. So, it was not my wife who read it, another person read it, and I said, Princess, is that true? Is there anything written on that? She said, yes. She read it as well. And then I said, you mean you are reading anything? It was just blank to me. Then I asked the third person, I said, can you try to read? Is there anything written there? He read the same words. I said, wow. I called the driver, please, can you see anything there? He said, of course, that's what is written. So I decided to see a doctor. So thank God for some people in the church, they took me for a checkup on my eyes.
Yeah.
When after they examined me, you will not believe this now. Listen closely. They said I was medically blind in one eye, and the other eye I had lost 60%. That right hand where they said I was medically blind, I had lost 85% of. And when you lose so much, you are already regarded as medically blind in that right eye. So it could see 15%, but you know, 85% is a lot. Because they tried, you know, I stood there, they tried this doctor, they tried that, they put all lenses that they had, and none of them went, you know, no improvement. And this one, they said it was not bad, it has lost 60%, but I could still see 5%. Now, I see the sister there. Is that the doctor there I'm seeing? Now I can see you just for you to as a testimony.
Я вижу врач.
What's her name? Galina?
Татьяна, я вижу врача моего здесь. Я наконец-то могу вас видеть. Я не мог видеть экран даже, а сейчас я вижу моего врача. Я узнаю вас. Встаньте, пожалуйста.
Я смог узнать ее с такого
расстояния. Не это ли доказательство?
That is the proof that something has happened between then and now.
Вот это доказательство, что что-то произошло между тем временем, о котором я рассказал, и сейчас.
Because I couldn't see from here to here.
Я не мог видеть из первого ряда на этот большой экран.
And now I could see her there.
А сейчас я узнал ее лицо аж там.
So anyway, they recommended me to go for. So they recommended me to, you know, go for to a special hospital for surgery.
И врачи, они сказали, что только операция может мне помочь, и нужно срочно сделать операцию в специальной больнице.
And they said this is not usual, this is not normal, because the diagnosis they had for me was cataract, and cataract is for people of old age. Here, the youngest person with cataract is 60 years old. So normally 70 to 80 years old. And here was a 40-year-old man with cataract. So anyway, I went to the for the operation.
Я пошел на операцию.
And they said it was successful.
Они сказали, хорошо прошла операция, успешно.
And they said I should come back for the test.
Сказали, я должен прийти снова для того, чтобы провериться.
They gave me 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, and no improvement.
И они мне дали один месяц, через два, через три месяца прийти. Сказали, операция успешна, но почему-то не наблюдается улучшений.
I was seeing the way I saw before.
Я видел так, как я видел и раньше до этого, до операции.
So they said, we don't know, but it happens like that. Let's do another operation.
Они сказали, ну, не знаю, но иногда так происходит, давайте мы еще одну операцию сделаем.
So they did the second operation.
Они еще одну операцию сделали.
You know, it's not operation on your teeth, this on your eyes. They cut the eyes and remove lens over there, you know, it's complicated. I mean, it's not very good for, you know, cutting your eyes inside. You know, that was something, you see.
И знаете, эта операция, это не просто где-то на щеке там у вас операция, это внутри, в самом глазу, они просто открывают глаз и внутри глаза режут. То есть это не что-то такое особо приятное, это очень серьезная вторая операция.
So they did the second operation.
Они сделали вторую операцию.
And they said it was supposed to be good.
И сказали, ну теперь точно все будет хорошо.
They said you are supposed to see at least 60 or 70%.
Сказали, вы должны видеть теперь где-то хотя бы 60 или 70%.
I did it. But the thing was still there. I was saying, my God, now, well, we'll see what God will do.
Даже после второй операции, к сожалению, мое зрение не намного улучшилось.
I went back there. They said, come back again.
Они сказали, вы приедете снова на проверку.
This was like last week.
Совсем недавно это было. На прошлой неделе я ездил туда.
But, you know, Victor was translating for Pastor Kumuyi.
Виктор переводил для пастора Кумуи.
And I felt like I should help and, you know, help him. And so I took the microphone.
И я почувствовал, что мне нужно ему помочь. Я взял микрофон.
And so I began to interpret.
И я начал переводить.
And as I was doing my job, Pastor began to, and I knew him.
И...
So it was, people who don't know him, I think it was just, you know. You know, guys saying some of the things he was saying, but I knew that was the word of knowledge.
И когда я переводил, пастор начал давать слово знания. И, ну, я точно, я хорошо его знаю. Я знаю, что это было слово знания.
But while he was there standing, he mentioned my case.
Когда он здесь стоял, я его переводил, он упомянул о моей проблеме.
I don't know if some of you will remember that he mentioned cataract specifically.
Я не знаю, помните ли вы, но он назвал катаракту.
And then at another instant, he said you had gone through operation.
И потом он еще сказал, что вам уже сделали операцию.
That's why it's embarrassing. That's why I said, for me as a pastor, you might not believe it because you are coming here. You think God is healing you all through pastor, but you will not believe the testimony. But also, God needed other people that He will also use to heal you.
Знаете, поэтому я и сказал в самом начале, что, наверное, это такое немножко свидетельство неудобное, да? Вы не ожидаете услышать такое свидетельство от пастора, потому что вы все приходите и ожидаете, что Бог вас исцелит через пастора, но.
Yes, I'm here to testify of the God's glory that is here.
Я здесь, чтобы свидетельствовать о Божьей славе, которая проявляется здесь.
And the God's glory not only here, it spreads all over the world through here.
И знаете, Божья слава не только здесь, но она распространяется по всему миру отсюда.
My wife 14 days ago gave birth to a baby boy.
Знаете, 14 дней назад моя супруга родила нам мальчика, сына.
Because of that, because of the birth and labor, she had complications and serious complications.
И знаете, к сожалению, после родов у нее были очень серьезные осложнения.
And she asked me to buy here in the pharmacies a medicine because a medicine here is a lot cheaper than in the United States.
И она мне позвонила и попросила купить здесь в аптеке лекарство определенное, потому что здесь оно намного дешевле, чем в Америке.
Yes, and at the first service when Pastor Kumuyi was preaching, he released the word of knowledge.
И на первом служении, на котором служил пастор Кумуи, он высвободил слово знания.
And I knew it in my spirit that this is for my wife.
И я знал в духе, что это для моей жены.
And my wife was watching online.
И моя жена смотрела прямую трансляцию.
And she sent a text message to me, I'm healed. She checked herself. And she was healed completely, instantly.
И моя жена, она прислала мне смс-ку. Она написала, что Бог исцелил меня абсолютно полностью.
Hallelujah!